What's good, everyone? I'm Forrest Walker, and hello from Istanbul, Turkey. So, I've been here in Istanbul for about 3 months, and it had been, I think, as normal as it really can get anywhere in the world right now. Definitely as normal as it has been for me anywhere during the pandemic. But that finally came to an end about a week ago. We went into a partial shutdown. Now we're going into basically a full shutdown, full lockdown on the weekends, curfew every day. Most things are closed. So we're back at it again. This will be my third city shutdown of the year. So I thought, why not make a video covering some of the main things I've done through these shutdowns to get through them as a photographer, because I know a lot of other people are starting shutdowns too. And for photographers, it's been really tough, but it's been tough for everyone. So let's get into it. I came up with five things that I think have really been helpful for me during the year and all these shutdowns. Starting with number one, which really it goes for everybody, and that's routine. Because these shutdowns, quarantines, everything, they really kill routine. Even if your work hasn't changed too much, but you're just working from home, your routine outside of work is messed up. I know my first couple weeks in Sao Paulo when I was piecing together work changes because of the shutdowns, my routine just got shot and I didn't have any structure and I lost motivation. So I really had to grab myself and put things back together and create some type of structure, some type of schedule. And I'm not just talking about work, but just everything. It can be little things just to get yourself motivated and keep going. It can be home workouts. It can be little projects around the house. Just some type of routine. It could be getting up and listening to music or reading a book at first when you wake up. There's a lot of different things you can do to keep yourself motivated and keep your spirits high. So routine is huge. But now starting with number two, we're going to get more specific towards photographers, and that's take photos, which sounds simple, but it's not so simple this year for a lot of people because it's tough out there. I know I teach mentorships, and the number one thing I hear is it's hard to get motivated to go out and take photos when there's not a whole lot happening outside. Life is not so interesting out there. Not as many people out there. They're masked up. You lose a lot of the expression and feeling. Just kind of depressing. And then if you're stuck at home, if your shutdown's like serious, then you can't even go out. What are you going to do there? But the thing is, you can keep taking photos no matter what. I mean, they might not be as interesting as they were before this year, but you need to keep the creativity going. If you're a photographer, you really have that passion. You really need to keep taking photos or you're just gonna get kind of depressed. You can take photos of pretty much anything, which brings me to number three, and that's think of some type of projects. That's the best way to motivate yourself to take photos. When it's not so interesting outside, that's not enough to motivate you. Think of a project that you can work on that can be anything. I know when I was in Sao Paulo, when the shutdown started, I didn't really know what to take photos of anymore because it wasn't fun out there. But I decided when I got there, I was photographing the carnival. If you're familiar with the carnival in Brazil, it's crazy. And Sao Paulo might not be Rio crazy, but it's still crazy. And for a couple weeks there's block parties everywhere, people partying everywhere on the streets. It's socializing, drinking, kissing. You see everything out there. It's basically the opposite of what you're going to see once the pandemic starts. And when it came to the pandemic this year, Carnival ended at the end of February, and then by mid-March, we were starting shutdown. So it changed so fast from the opposite of social distancing and all that social interaction and fun and love, and then go straight to the pandemic where the streets are somber, people are keeping away from each other. It really changed so much. And then if you're familiar with what happened in Brazil, it became an epicenter of the pandemic. So it got really bad there. And then you had all this political unrest. And by the end, I was having to go through tear gas just to take photos. It got so crazy. So I at least had something to focus on. So I photographed all that from one end of the spectrum to the other. And I'm actually going to make that a zine. That helped a lot, really, because it gave me something to focus on when it came to photography, which got me out there shooting. So just think of some type of project. It doesn't have to be as crazy as that or complex as that. If you're stuck at home, just think of a project at home. Think of a family project, whoever you live with. Just think of a project to keep you taking photos, which brings me to number four, and that is not just take photos, but look through your photos that you've already taken. Go through your archives. I know a lot of people have tons of photos that they haven't even really looked through. For me, I went through all my archives. I was already trying to piece together my book that's coming out next year, and also decided to piece together some zines. So I went through my archive a ton, but that led to a lot of different things. You can find photos that that you like that you don't even remember taking, or you can piece together connections that you didn't realize you had. You can make different series. Maybe you find enough connections that you can make a zine or even a book out of it. Who knows? But it's a great idea to go through your archives because you get inspiration from that. I know on Instagram, what I did was I started a series Sundays that you can check out on there. People definitely like those posts the most, and they've been fun for me to piece together because I found all these connections in my archive that I was able to put together around 10 photo series, and that's been a lot of fun. So just go through your archives, maybe go through other people's work too, not just your own work. You can do a lot of different things. Also, going through my archive and having more time on my hands during the shutdowns, I decided to send more work into different festivals, magazines, grants, and things like that, which ended up being one of the best things of the year for me because I won a few, like the Italian Street Photography Festival, Urban Awards, 35 awards, quite a few. It was actually really good for that. And then also I was a finalist in a lot, featured in different magazines. So that was something to keep motivation up to. I actually just found out yesterday I am a finalist of the Miami Street Photography Festival too. So in a year where there's not a whole lot of positives, at least there's a few positives there. So just go through your photos, take a lot of photos. And that brings me to number 5, which is just make plans, make goals, think ahead, try to think past the bad things happening and work towards the future and things that I've done. Of course, making zines and books, those are goals that I've worked towards. But if your work's affected like it was for me with workshops, then I transitioned more into mentorships online from some of the people that I had to cancel the workshops on. I'm still gonna do workshops in the future, but mentorships has actually been a fun thing to get into, which I'm gonna keep doing too. And I've come up with different projects. Obviously, I'm working on videos now. I'm coming up with a subscription service soon. So there's a lot of things you can work on. And then I have a lot of different plans for once we get out of this. Next year, I have 3 different zines coming out and a book. So there's a lot of things to work towards and just keep hope alive because this will end. And that brings me to the end, which really, there's one more thing, is just stay healthy. Staying inside and not doing a whole lot is not great for your immune system. So try to do as much as you can to keep your immune system going, stay healthy so we can get through this and get back to what we love doing. So for all the photographers also going through shutdowns out there, or really anyone going through shutdowns out there, good luck. Let's get through this. I'm actually not going to be here too much longer. My visa was going to end anyway, and I still can't get back to my home base in Asia. So I booked a ticket actually to Minsk, Belarus, which I haven't been to. We might even add that to the project, the major city project. We'll see, even though that's done. But why not? I haven't been there yet. So we'll see how that goes. They actually don't have any shutdowns. Hopefully that doesn't change. But that's what's going to happen. So I'm going to bring you some content from there when that happens. But we have more content from Istanbul coming too. I have a few videos already in the making. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon. Cheers.